हेलो, आई एम पंकज, पंकज दीवान, फाउंडर एंड सीईओ ऑफ आइडिया लैब्स. इट्स ऑलवेज ग्रेट टू बी हियर एट द हाइसिया एनुअल प्रोडक्ट अवार्ड्स. आई हैव बीन कमिंग हियर फॉर द लास्ट 5 years. इनफैक्ट आई हैव बीन द जूरी चेयर फॉर वन ऑफ द कैटेगरीज फॉर द लास्ट 4 years. इट्स अ वेरी प्रेस्टिजियस सेट ऑफ अवार्ड्स बिकॉज इट्स एन अवार्ड गिवन बाय द इंडस्ट्री पीयर्स टू द इंडस्ट्री, स्टार्टअप्स, एंटरप्राइज एंड ऑल अदर कैटेगरीज. Right, so it's great to come here, meet all the people, network all the people, and like our IT minister Mr. KTR spoke today in terms of how Hyderabad is spearheading and now becoming has already become the number 2 exporter in India. So I think it's wonderful to be here and meet everyone at this awards. Thank you.
Hi, I am Ajay. I am the CEO of Consent Solutions Private Limited, and our solution was Hilfa. We won the best award for COVID-19 solution and really feel great about it in these times where everybody is suffering and we are able to help people at large. And Hysia has been really supporting us, including T-Hub and the local companies a lot. Thank you.
ఈ రోజు హైసియా యాన్యువల్ అవార్డ్స్ నైట్ ఫంక్షన్లో హైదరాబాద్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఎక్స్పోర్ట్స్ అసోసియేషన్ నుంచి ఈరోజు ఇచ్చిన అవార్డ్ డిఫరెంట్ కేటగిరీస్ కానివ్వండి. వైస్ ప్రెసిడెంట్ ఆఫ్ హైసియా మిస్టర్ కిరణ్ చెరుగురి గారు,
ఫస్ట్ టైం హైసియా ట్రైడ్ అవుట్ హైబ్రిడ్ ఈవెంట్, ఐ థింక్ విత్ ద ఆర్డర్ ఆఫ్ ద డే టుడే ఐ థింక్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద కంపెనీస్ హస్ మూవ్డ్ టు వర్క్ ఫ్రమ్ హోమ్ మోర్ రైట్ అండ్ సో వి ట్రైడ్ అవుట్ ఎ వర్చువల్ ఈవెంట్ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ దిస్ ఇయర్. And the conference and then expo part is on a virtual platform, and then the physical awards is in the awards evening is done here. Mm-hmm. I think it was a grand success. There were about 1200 delegates who had tuned in throughout the 4 hours of the entire actually virtual summit. And we could actually, thanks to the hybrid format, and then we've been able to reach across to the global leaders and then global speakers. And then I think there are certain panels, we have people joining in from 4 time zones. Mm-hmm. Very, very valuable perspectives that they have given. And I think there's a very, very, this conference marks the resilience of the IT industry in Hyderabad. Right, even in difficult times, I think we've been able to actually put together a splendid event, and it was a grand success. Every year, so there are 9 categories, product awards are in 9 categories. There are 15 awards in the service category primarily. Service awards is primarily, there are 3 layers of companies basically, very large companies which are 10,000 crores and above. And then there are companies in 1,000 crores and above. And then there are companies in 200 crores and above. So all the 3 categories. And then we have exporters as well as actually 2 special awards that are being actually introduced in this year. One is actually highest number of women employment created in Hyderabad is one. And then highest number of net new employment created by a company in the past year. These are the 2 special awards. And then this year, the Lifetime Achievement Award has been given to J. Sachinarayan Garu, ex-IAS officer, and then UDAI chairman as well. KTR Garu, primarily, I think this year is a little bit unprecedented year, right? And then we never experienced the situation that which we had experienced. Starting with COVID pandemic, and then the lockdowns imposed, and then entire life came to stand still, right? In that situation, IT industry is actually which very, very swift to respond, and then actually moved from work from office to work from home mode. So government has been very, very supportive during this period. The police department, medical and health department, and the central agencies like STPI and then SEZ was very, very cooperative, and then enabled us to move in 72 hours from work from office to work from home mode, right? That's an area. So I think he was also recognizing the fact that like this is one vertical and one industry which has actually swiftly responded and then actually gone back to the normal mode. Typically, right? So business is not impacted, and there are not many layoffs that have happened, right? That's one. The second point which he had made is primarily IT industry collectively actually supported during the pandemic about 100 crore rupees. The industry is collected along with the other associations in Hyderabad, and then spent for a very purposeful areas basically. So that's another thing. The third is the areas actually how an ecosystem is being developed. Okay, and then HYSEA, along with some of the government, quasi-government agencies like TASC, T-Hub, okay, Telangana Innovation Council, and then some of these basically how collaboratively HYSEA is working with them, and then creating an overall ecosystem so that like we will be able to brand Telangana is a very, very investment-friendly destination. So those are the points which he has made. So typically what happens is the fiscal year in India is some companies which are MNCs follow December, January to December closure, but majority of the Indian companies April to March typically, right? So most of the HYSEA plans also get firmed up in the month of March. But otherwise, like whenever there is a new EC that takes over, I think, which has happened in the month of May, of 2020, the new EC has taken over, new president has taken over, right? So we do a two-year planning primarily. Okay, so I think our plans are in place typically. I think there is a huge focus on SMEs. There 80% of the HYSEA membership is small and medium enterprises, right? They are the hubs of innovation, and then they are primarily responsible for the growth of the industry typically, but the needs of the SMEs are different. So HYSEA is actually worked with closely with the Telangana government, and then instrumental in constituting an advisory committee. The president of HYSEA, and then me, and four representatives from the government, okay, are part of the SME advisory committee for the state. And then we have several initiatives that are getting rolled out to support the SME. Yeah, absolutely. So there are two, multiple areas actually. HYSEA in itself is not a company, but it represents 90% of the Hyderabad Hyderabad exporters industry, right? So that way what happens is talent is one of the very, very important areas for the growth of the industry, right? And then corporate social responsibility is another area. Growth of small and medium enterprises as well as the startups is another area of important. So HYSEA primarily focuses on, through its forums and then committees, strengthening some of these areas. So our Industry Academia Forum is working relentlessly in terms of creating that kind of an ecosystem, and then closely work with TASC in terms of how do we ensure that like there is more and more people are project ready and then more employable in the state. So that's one area. The other area is corporate social responsibility. I just mentioned that like IT industry came together and then actually collected about 100 crore rupees. So that's another area that which HYSEA works indirectly helps.
Big contribution.
The finally, I think HYSEA has been the consultative body for any new company which is coming into Hyderabad. So they actually consults us and then interacts with the HYSEA managing committee and understands how the talent situation in the state, and then how actually the overall infrastructure of the state, what government of Telangana is doing to improve the infrastructure, okay, whether it could be connectivity or decongestion of the city, and then sectorial policies of the city, talent availability. So all of these actually HYSEA advises the new companies which are going to come. Probably Hyderabad is one of the choice for them from the many other options that they have in India. But I think Hyderabad has been attracting so many companies in the past several years. Yeah. Thanks a lot. Thanks.